Good morning, everyone. Thank you for joining us today. My name is Nomaswazi Nxumalo, and welcome to the SAGEA Virtual Career Fair. This session is titled The Life of a Webber Wentzel Candidate Attorney, The Truth, The Whole Truth, and Nothing But The Truth. Ooh, I am super, super excited about that. Basically, we'll be giving you the 411, okay? So don't go anywhere. Speaking to this topic today, we have four of our candidate attorneys. You have me, hello. We have James Baikoff, Kiara Ghirao, and Lesiba Legodi. So what we're each going to do is we're each going to introduce ourselves, tell you a little bit about our days or our nights as candidate attorneys. You know, our highlights, our lowlights, our midlights, everything really. You know, everything that we've experienced and we think will be valuable and useful to you in your journey. Okay, and at the end of our presentations, we will respond to a couple of questions. So please, please, please do send through those questions. You can ask us anything, of course, within reason. And we will focus on those questions that we are best placed to speak to. And if we don't get to your question in this session, or if you have more questions to ask us, chat to us. We are online today and tomorrow on our virtual stand. So do visit our virtual stand where you'll get to engage with more of our other candidate attorneys, as well as our graduate recruitment team. Okay, so let's start our session. We've promised you the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. So James, what's your truth?
Okay, good morning, everyone. My name is James Baikoff, and I'm a second year candidate attorney at Webber Wentzel in the Johannesburg office. So I grew up and went to school in Cape Town, and straight after school, I went on a gap year where I played cricket in England before coming back and studying at the best university in South Africa, UCT. So at UCT, I did a business science, economics and law, which is basically just a fancy way of saying I did an honors in economics with an LLB. So now I'm currently in my third rotation, and it's my final rotation, and I'm part of the investment funds team. So I have previously rotated through the competition team and the media and defamation law team. Now, a day in the life of a CA in each of these teams is quite different. So a lot of the time you're doing research and engaging with clients and drafting memos and opinions, but if you're in litigation, you will also be doing a lot of printing. A lot of printing. So my current rotation is great and I'm absolutely loving it because I'm getting the opportunity to sort of do a lot of drafting, which is something I've really been enjoying. But what you'll realize and what you'll find is that each team is so different and so unique, so learn as much as you can. But naturally, things have been very different to when we first started at the firm. You're no longer able to sort of establish a rapport as easily with the people in your team by simply sort of walking into their offices and having a chat and asking questions about the work that you've been given. And this is something that I've really struggled with. But what's helped me a lot during these times is that I found that the people in the teams that I've worked in are so nice and so willing to help. So I've learned not to be afraid to ask all of my silly questions, because even though everyone's so busy, everyone's very understanding. But what I will say is that there is a big transition from varsity to work life. Studying the law, practicing the law are two very different things. You have to understand that although you may have gotten very good marks in university, it doesn't mean that much now. So you'll do an opinion or draft a letter or whatever, and you think you've done a phenomenal job, and then the next thing you get it back and the majority of it is in red line. I've learned that you've got to have a bit of a thick skin when it comes to getting feedback, but this is by far the best way to learn. I will say though that one super important thing is that you need to almost throw away any sort of preconceived ideas that you might have had with regards to the type of law that you think you like and what you think you don't like. The amazing thing about Webber is that, or in my opinion, is that you get the opportunity to sort of do three rotations. So you actually get exposed to different areas of law and get an opportunity to figure out what you like and what you don't like. But I'm going to be real with you. You're going to work very, very, very hard, and you will sometimes work extremely long hours. You're going to become best friends with the printers, and trying to balance the work, your work life, and studying for all four board exams is no joke. Because yes, at Webber, it's compulsory to write all four board exams. just ask the first year CAs who are about to go on study leave. But the thing is, you get through it. Every challenge you face helps you grow. And the great thing is that although work might be tough and the hours might be long, everything you're going through is developing you for the better. But enough with the doom and gloom. I really enjoyed my time at Webber. And I'll just go quickly through some highlights just to showcase how much being at Webber sort of pushes you to grow and be the best that you can be. So in my first rotation, the competition team, I got to work on some incredible mergers, such as the JSE Link merger. And I was also fortunate enough to have an article published in Without Prejudice. In my second rotation in media and defamation, I got to go to the Zondo Commission and also work on some incredible matters. I also managed to pass all four board exams first time, but I think my proudest achievement that I've had so far at Webber is we had an inter-team bake-off, and I've never baked anything in my entire life, and I managed to bake a tart. I mean, I did come last, but that's not really the point. But yeah, if I had to sort of pinpoint my favorite time as a CA over these past 2 years, I'd probably say the initial first period, the first month, where all the Webber CAs came up to Joburg and we were getting to know each other and getting to know the firm. And we'd all work really hard during the week. And then at 4:30 every Friday, everyone would go up to the bar on the seventh floor and you get your drink of choice, whether that was alcoholic or non-alcoholic. And it really gave you a chance to sort of interact and meet everyone within the firm, whether that would be other CAs or partners or whatever. And it, I don't know, it kind of made you feel like you were part of something special. So yeah, hopefully that will come back soon. But yeah, being at Webber for me, no matter what team you're in, you're going to be working with the absolute best lawyers in the business. It's such a unique and incredible opportunity to be at a firm like this. And yeah, who knows, you might even get to take part in a bake-off. Thanks.
Good day. I am Lesiba Legodi. I'm currently a candidate attorney at Webber Wentzel. I was born and raised in Johannesburg, and after matric, I took the wise decision to study a four-year LLB at the University of KwaZulu-Natal in Durban. And true to my love for travel, I then made the decision to move to Cape Town to do my articles. I found the transition from university to varsity to be quite quirky in that I started my articles at the tender age of 21. And I found myself in a new city with the only people that I knew were a couple of high school friends and my new colleagues whom I'd only spent a month of orientation with. This, however, not only forced me to get out of my comfort zone, but to also adapt. I practiced little that I know would be a prequel to my entire articles journey at Webber Wentzel. I started in the shipping team with little maritime shipping experience and a lot of anxiety, mainly because I was in a new environment with legal professionals who've been at it for what feels like my entire existence. But soon, my nerves soon settled, and as I got to know my colleagues better, I thoroughly enjoyed my rotation. I must say that one of my key highlights was definitely conducting my first shipping arrest, and as well as co-authoring an article published in the International Bar Association. My second rotation was in the corporate team, which was significantly different from my first rotation. I found this one to be a bit more challenging in that I worked longer hours and had quick turnaround times between deadlines. I must say that I often found myself questioning what value could I possibly add to such a big team, but then my fears soon subsided when I realized that firstly, I'm working in a team, and secondly, there are many moving parts and each role is just as important as the other. I am grateful to have done a great corporate rotation in that I learned a great deal of skills, and I hope to carry these skills far into my legal career. Some of my sticking points, which I will fondly remember, was working on high profile matters as well as multi-jurisdictional matters. I'm currently doing my second rotation in dispute resolution, where my duties largely entail court attendance, filing papers, indexing and pagination, and preparing court bundles, basically making my partners and my superiors' jobs a little easier. When I'm not at court, I'm currently in the office surviving paper cuts, preparing meeting notes, on consultations hand and conducting legal research and drafting opinions on the research conducted. Throughout my articles, I've managed to forge what I would like to hope to be lifelong relationships with my colleagues, and this has also helped me manage and balance the challenges of work. I've also been fortunate enough to have a strong support system, both in the workplace and out of the workplace, which has helped me stay grounded in this fast-paced environment. And it also offers me constant reassurance when my Mondays, Sundays, Tuesdays, or any other day of the week are blue. One of the other things that have actually stuck out to me throughout working in this COVID world is that this notion of a work-life balance seems to be a myth, but rather it has shown that it is more suited to a work-life integration, which is far more realistic and attainable. Thank you very much for listening to my journey to date. I'm now handing over to my colleague, Nomaswazi. Over to you, Nomaswazi.
Thank you, Lesiba. So as I've already said, my name is Nomaswazi. A little bit about myself. I was raised in Soweto. I then moved to the East Rand for a couple of years. Then I went to the University of Pretoria, 5 long years. And that's where I did my BCom Law and my LLB. And yeah, man, now we're here. I'm a second year doing my third and final rotation as a litigation candidate attorney. So my first rotation was in tax. My second rotation was in TMT and IP, which is short for telecommunications, media and technology and intellectual property. Got it. And now, as I said, I'm in litigation. So each of our rotations are 8 months long. And let me tell you, 8 months sounds like a long time, but it goes by so, so quickly. I feel like I just walked into the doors of Webber Wentzel as a first year, and all of a sudden we're in our last rotation. So as James said, it is in your best interest to make sure that you do as much as you can, you learn as much as you can in each and every one of those rotations, be available. A senior associate in one of my previous teams actually said to me that as a candidate attorney, you are the least experienced person, and therefore you should be the most available person. And my goodness, the availability aspect for me was something that I had to get used to very, very quickly, because I had to learn a lot of time management. Okay, one of the differences between varsity and being a CA, I mean, you know, with the obvious one being that you have a lot more money now, but you know, one of the differences is that here time moves differently. Okay, you will get deadlines like you have never gotten deadlines before. You know, in varsity, beginning of the semester, you have all your what is it called? All your semester test dates. You have all your assignment dates. There's no surprises. That's when you're going to do that assignment, and that's when you're going to write that test. But here, you'll get an instruction at 10 a.m. and it's due at 10:30 a.m. And you better do it, and you better do it well. So, and on top of that, also, there's other instructions coming through. Due dates are close to each other. Due dates are the same. So yeah, it's something you have to learn. And I've never been a timetable kind of person, but I've had to be that person. Yeah, because you do not want to miss deadlines. It affects everyone on the team. Okay. And also, you are responsible for your own learning. You know, and as much as we have training sessions at the firm, you need to be responsible for being on top of things. For example, a new court directive comes out, you know, sure, it's not relevant to you now, but read it, understand it, make sure you know what it's about, because trust, in a week or two, when you least expect it, someone's going to come and ask you about it. And sure, you do have time to go and do some research, but for that 5 seconds when your partner's asking what's happening, you're going to be staring them blank in the face. You don't want to be that person. So I'm not saying learn everything off by heart. Of course, we're not computers, but you know, at least have an idea of what's happening. Yeah, and that helped me at least. Okay, so let's talk about something fun, okay? So I am one half of the CA Social Committee. And what we do is in the name. You know, we make sure that CAs have social events. We make sure that CAs stay connected, or at least we tried. You know, COVID took that one away from us. And rather unfortunate, really, because we couldn't have gatherings or anything. But the one thing that we did successfully as the social committee is the CA video. And what that is at the end of the first year, all CAs gather together, they write, they shoot, they direct a short video. And basically it just, you know, talks about our experience as first years and, you know, all our inside jokes and whatnot. And at the year end function, every single person at the firm gets to watch that video. So that was exciting to do. Every CA involved in that, I hope they agree with me. Every CA on this call, I hope agrees with me that that was fun. You know, for most of us, it was the first time we all got together after lockdown. And I think for most of us as well, it was the first time we saw each other since March. Because, you know, we were all working from home. We were all like this on computers. So yeah, and I personally was super happy to see everyone again, especially because I stay by myself, and that's one of the challenges I had to, you know, that I experienced. And you know what I appreciate about the people at Webber Wentzel is, although we couldn't meet face to face, partners, associates, fellow candidate attorneys, everyone was more than willing to share a cup of coffee with you over a Teams meeting or just have a quick chat, you know, just so you have the human element still there. And I really, really appreciated that. So last piece of advice then that ties into that is find your people, find people that will help you grow, find people that will help you develop, because you know what, it is impossible to do this by yourself. All right, and that's me, Kiara. Over to you.
Thank you, Nomaswazi. Good morning, everyone. My name is Kiara Ghirao, and I am 24 years old. I was born in KZN, and then I moved to Johannesburg at the age of 1 year old. I have always lived in the Rand Park area, and I've attended Rand Park Primary and Rand Park High. After my matric, I then went to study a BA LLB at Wits. I did my BA in International Relations. So if any of you are witsy on this call, then hey! So my journey at Webber Wentzel started in 2018, where I had my first interview with HR, and then I got invited to attend the two-week vacation program in July of 2018, which I attended for 2 weeks. And then I got offered to attend articles in 2020, which I then commenced at the beginning of last year. And boy, it has been a journey ever since. So the typical normal day of a life of a CA will depend on the type of team that you get rotated into and the amount of work and volume of work that you have during that time. So you're going to rotate 3 times at Webber, as mentioned, and I served my first rotation in dispute resolution with a focus on construction law and disputes. In this rotation, and so far, I got to work on complex matters. I've got to deal with clients and companies that I'd only see on the news. I have got to go to court and attend arbitrations, and I've got to draft many, many documents. However, I have also spent many weekends here alone making over 50 files with paper cuts, and honestly, that is just the reality of being a CA at times. You're going to work hard and long hours, and I had to learn how to plan my life according to that and not to make any plans if you know urgent work had to come up. You're not going to work that normal 8 to 5 working hours from a Monday to Friday. So just prepare yourself if you think that's the life that you're going to come for. So my work has always been determined by the seniors in my teams. And so when I adjusted coming from university, I always had my own times and I worked my own pace at university. And coming to work was really, really difficult for me. I had to adjust to working to crazy long hours as well as working to the pace of my team, which was difficult, but eventually you do learn to find your own working styles and you will adapt to that. Okay, so then I rotated to the competition law team after James, and due to COVID, we dealt with a lot of companies that did excessive pricing and were breaching a lot of competition law rules. In this team, I got to learn a lot of international law and I got to do some maths, which was pretty cool because it was very different and fun considering that all I did thinking is the law. This is also a very big team, and I had to learn how to communicate with different personalities, which was also something that I wasn't used to. Additionally, our team also worked from home, and I had to learn to work virtually and adapt just like everyone else in the world. So my advice is that if you're going to be working virtually, to let the people that you're living with know when you have meetings, to have stable and reliable internet connection, and just to always be connected, and to always show your capacity on Microsoft Teams. My highlight from Webber Wentzel came in this team when I got to publish my first ever article in the Without Prejudice legal magazine. And this is something that I love about Webber Wentzel. It's the ability to train, upskill, and invest in the people. I am now in the pro bono department, and we help communities whose rights have been infringed. One of the partners I serve under, Murray Haythorn, he's one of the leading experts, and he's a founder of probono.org. Learning under him, you know, it can be intimidating, but I consider myself a sponge and I just absorb as much as I can from him. And then going to board exams, guys, board exams were really, really tough. I'm not going to lie. It was my first time ever working and studying at the same time. So for me personally, I did find that a bit difficult. You know, we had to attend hours of classes online. Some were taken on Saturdays and Sundays from 8 to 4 p.m. You are working these long, crazy hours, and then you still have to find the time to study, which can be very difficult. But however, you will push through, you'll get the time, and you know your studying style, your working style, and you will just push through. And by the grace of God, I have managed to pass all of my board exams. And after writing board exams, I told myself that I wasn't going to lift another textbook. However, Webber Wentzel has provided us with the opportunity to now write our notarial board exams. And it's something that I can't miss. It's an opportunity that they have given us. And again, it's showing that they want to upskill and train, and they're investing in us. And it's something that I am very drawn into and something that I will be doing. So that's all for me today. Thank you, everyone. And I'll be moving on to the Q&A session. So I'll be going, so please send through your questions. We received our first question from Bongo, which asked if Webber Wentzel offers bursaries for any law students. Our response, so firstly, thank you all for joining. And then our response is that we have a scholarship program which offers partial financial support for studies in your penultimate or intermediate year and a final year LLB. Applications close on the 1st of October, 2021, and you can find the link in our chat box. Okay, I'm just going on to our next question. Okay, our second question asks, if a student is in their final year for BCom law degree, what will you be studying towards your LLB after completion? And is it possible for them to receive funding or a bursary during your final year of your BCom? And unfortunately not, you may apply for assistance with funding for the postgrad LLB, and our applications close again on the 1st of October, 2021, and you can find the link in our chat box. Our third question asks, if we offer part-time or seasonal training, may you please elaborate what you mean on training? Okay, our other questions that have come through from a person has asked that they are a management consultant with a BCom in finance and a BCom in law. They've asked if we offer any opportunities for those looking for career change aren't necessarily fresh graduates. Specifically, do we offer opportunities for people with a BCom law and not an LLB? So our response is, unfortunately, you cannot work as an attorney without an LLB. Our firm does offer other career options, which does support our business. And we would suggest completing your LLB if you want to join the candidate attorney program. Okay, our next question is from a second year of a BCom studies and will be starting an LLB in 2023. When can you apply for your candidate attorney program? So you can apply for the candidate attorney program in 2023. If you want to find out what life is like at Webber Wentzel, you may apply for the Webber Wentzel experience in 2022. So please keep a lookout for that information of both opportunities and just keep checking the website, and please check all our social media pages. Okay, so I have some questions here. That says, it seems that some of you moved away from your homes to do articles in Johannesburg. How did you manage that transition? So that the floor is open either to all three of you have moved. So
I don't mind going first. So basically for me moving up to Joburg, it was difficult. But I think it was a really good learning opportunity. It's something that kind of completely threw me out of my comfort zone and really forced me to adapt. What also helped in a big way was that I moved up with a couple of people. So people from university were also coming to Joburg. So that helped me a lot. And what you'll find though at Webber is you're going to make some incredible friends. So yeah, going through it all together really, really does help a lot. And everyone's super welcoming and friendly. So yeah. Lesiba, do you wanna hop on here?
Yes, happy to hop on, James. I feel like me and you went opposite directions, where you went from Cape Town to Joburg and I went from Joburg to Cape Town. And it was tricky in the beginning, like I must say, especially because I moved here not knowing anybody. And it was actually my second time in Cape Town ever. I'd previously been here for my interview. I thoroughly enjoyed it. I have a strong support system at home. I've also gotten to make some good friends on the side as well. And yes, as James mentioned, colleagues as well. You spend a lot of time with them, so you're bound to forge those bonds with them. But yeah.
Thank you, Lesiba. So you definitely will try to get your work family, you know, from working and moving away from home. And our next question asked, what type of students does Webber Wentzel recruit? Is social activities, can you take part in any social activities? Does that make any sense? So, okay, I'll take this one. So if you look at the four of us, we are completely different people. I don't think that Webber Wentzel has a one box size and they don't look for one certain candidate attorney. Your academics cannot be terrible. You know, this is a big five firm and you do need to know the law. So you need to have a 65% average, but you need to be an all-rounder. So you do need to set yourself apart from the millions and thousands of law students out there. So for example, I tried to take part in social events. I tried to take part in the Law Student Council when I was at university. I tried to take part in many of the firm's events that they would post on social media, and that's where I would get involved. I don't know if anyone else, Swazi, if you want to comment.
Yes, definitely. I agree with you, Kiara. There is no one box that they expect us all to be in. You know, we are all different, as you said. So in varsity, I actually didn't do any law-related activities. So I was part of like the student sports committee. I was a tutor. I was, you know, an MC, et cetera, et cetera. I think the point is just be a well-rounded student. Of course, your marks have to be above the 65% average, but be well-rounded in the sense that when you get here, there's so much that you have to do at the same time that you already need to know how to handle that. My 2 cents.
Thank you, Nomaswazi. Okay, thank you. So our next question is, how does the firm support you with working from home during COVID?
I can take this one. It's been obviously a trying time. I think the catchphrase is unprecedented times, but the firm really has done everything that it can to assist us in these difficult years. I mean, especially being CAs, like these are the years where you need to be in the office and learning from people, but they really have done everything that they can to assist us with all of our training. So instead of having training in person, they've basically opened up training for all of the different sectors on Teams, so you can tune in and really get a sense of the different teams and get exposure that way, which has been really, really cool. The firm is very supportive of everything going on at the moment. So, yeah.
Thank you, James. I can attest to that. I think the firm has also assisted us with giving us, they've given us money to purchase airtime so we could always stay connected. The firm has also provided us with screens so we could work from home during this time, which is very helpful. So that's how they have assisted us. I see that we've run out of time, so I'm just going to quickly take the last question that I can see on here, which is, what is your interaction with the partners? Do you engage with them a lot, or is it hierarchy? Anyone can take this question.
Happy to take it. So currently, it depends on team to team. You do get those big teams that are filled with partners, associates, senior associates, and then CAs. Your instructions mainly flow from the person directly above you. However, I find myself in the fortunate position where it's just me and the partner. So there is more added responsibility on my shoulders, and I do have interactions with the partner as well. So, yeah.
Yeah, and I think it's also important to remember that partners aren't these big and scary people at the top of the firm. They are very approachable, and I think that's one of the things I appreciate. Like I said, it's easy to just call one of them, say, you know, let's have a cup of coffee, or I have this bothering me, can I talk to you about it? So approach them.
Definitely. Thank you, everyone, and thank you for sending through your questions, and thank you for joining the session. I am now going to hand over to Lesiba, who's going to close off.
Thank you, Kiara, and thank you to everyone else for your questions and your participation. Unfortunately, that's all we have time for in this session. If there are any questions we don't get a chance to respond to, please feel free to visit our virtual stand where you can engage with some of the other candidate attorneys as well as our graduate recruitment team. And thank you for everyone who has joined us and attended on our journey so far. On behalf of Webber Wentzel, we wish you great success on the road ahead. And we hope that by attending this session today, we offered you some insight on finding the right path for you. For more information, please do visit our website on www.webberwentzel.com. Thank you.